Okay, so we're going to continue where we left off yesterday, and I want to review with you the hero's journey. Okay, I want to review with you the hero's journey. Who can tell me the first stage of the hero's journey? You can look it up. You can look it up in your notes. What's the first stage in the hero's journey? Ariana. The call. Okay. Now let's give a little bit more information today. We're gonna add a little bit more information. What is the point of the call? What happens during the call? Ethan?
Bring the character into the story.
Yes. So what brings the character into the story? Let's come up with a different couple different possibilities. One, something is missing. Something in the hero's life is missing. And the hero's looking to complete it. Okay? What could be another reason that a hero joins the journey? Yeah.
Like a natural disaster or something. Like something natural, like fate brings the hero in.
Fate brings the hero in. We need to be a bit more specific though. I want to break it down.
And is the cause sort of like the inciting incident?
It's similar, but it's specifically about what brings the hero into the journey. So we have something is missing. We have wanting to save a family member. Maybe a family member, a friend is in pain. What else? What else could bring a hero into the journey? Yeah.
Defeat and antagonist.
Pardon?
Defeat and antagonist.
But we have to know why. These are the whys. You're telling me what happens. I want to know why. Why does a hero even begin? Well, something's missing from the hero's life. Hero feels compelled to save someone. And sometimes it's an unwilling entry. Because maybe someone's kidnapped, right? Or maybe someone is pushed into try something they don't want to. It's not always a willing experience. But you have to think, what's the call? What brings the hero into it? Okay, now, before the hero actually enters the journey completely, what does the hero have to cross? What does the hero have to cross? Catherine?
The threshold.
The threshold. And how would you define the threshold?
A choice.
No, a threshold is a place. What is the threshold? It is a place. It is a place. David?
Like the home or
No. Threshold, think of this. This is like a threshold right here. The first day you came into class, this is the threshold. Outside is more familiar. It's the outside part of the hallway, right? Safe. Is everyone else here? It looks familiar. Okay, it's a hallway. It's a hallway. I don't want to go. Why not? Why might someone not want to come in? Why might someone not want to come in? Anika?
Because it's an unfamiliar place.
That's right. And that's what a threshold is. Familiar, unfamiliar in front of you, familiar behind you. The threshold is a place. So I think some of you needed to fine-tune that understanding. By the way, when's your test? You guys know? Did you look at the calendar? When's your test? Next week. So how important is it for you to be tuned into class right now? Very important, because guess what? When you tune into class, what don't you have to do at home? You don't have to study. But if you wait on, and you go home, would you even know what to study? No, the words on the page don't mean anything. Threshold is a place, okay? And this is where Catherine's right. Crossing the threshold is a choice. Crossing the threshold is a choice, okay. Now, to help you survive the new territory, who helps you?
Mentor.
Who helps you? What is that called? Adam?
Threshold guardians.
The threshold guardians, thank you very much. And the point of the threshold guardian is to protect the hero from entering a journey before they're too ready, before they're ready. Okay? But once they're ready, so we have guardians, what does this represent? What does that represent? Do you have it in your notes? Dustin?
Trials.
Okay, so we're calling it tests.
Tests.
trials, ordeals. And why do I have it in steps? Why do I have this in steps? Angelina?
Because each test basically gets harder and harder.
Perfect. So I want you to draw an arrow. The tests and trials is about growth. Tests, trials, and ordeals is all about growing so that the hero becomes ready, okay? So we talk about how are they growing. We can see them growing socially. They can grow with knowledge or cognitively, and they can grow physically. And socially, psychologically, I might put those kind of in the same way. Okay, so they're growing and growing and growing until finally the hero will then be comfortable enough to do what? To go where? To encounter what, I should say. To encounter what? Encounter what? Cynthia?
The abyss.
The abyss. And how would you define the abyss?
It's the hardest challenge.
That's right. The hardest challenge. And what you might even draw a little dragon. Because when I first was learning about the hero's journey, it's often referred, the abyss is like slaying the dragon. That giant dragon. I think of Sleeping Beauty. I don't know, maybe you don't know that.
Maybe the Hobbit.
Or the Hobbit. Who's that big person? Schmell?
Smog.
Schmell. Okay, so the abyss is the biggest challenge, okay? Now, when the hero, this is really, really important, this part here. The hero has to choose to enter the abyss. The hero is never just pushed into it. The hero has to choose, I'm talking to the camera, choose the abyss. Am I recording myself? Yes, I am. Okay? Choose to fall into the abyss. Choose to succumb. Okay? Give in to the challenge. Now, when the hero emerges, do you guys remember when we talked about this in Hatch? I talked about it for just a small bit. I said, oftentimes in literature, writers will use this to signify transformation. Does anyone remember what that is? Dilip. That's right. So in this place, transformation, we're going to look for some kind of death and rebirth, or sleep and rebirth. And you understand that sleep is a symbol of death, right? A death to what? The old. Yes.
To the old self.
Yes. Death to the hero, the person who wasn't the hero. Because it's only after the hero goes through all of this that that title becomes worthy. Okay? So there's some kind of sleep and rebirth, and then what happens in the end? What does the hero do?
Return home.
As now with a new title. With a new title, okay? Now, we're gonna read Rikki Tikki Tavi and look for this. Okay, are you ready to read that? Yes? Okay, how much of it did we read yesterday?